Hallelujah. Amen. He's coming ferociously. Hallelujah. Amen. So it's not small. It's not something small that you see. Just this is powerful windstorm. Hallelujah. The one that can throw you away. That can take these cars and throw. You see the car. The car is in the air like this. Yes, the kind of storm it comes and then it lifts these zigs up. Take this up and then it takes it with it and then it, you just see the zigs
flying.
Hallelujah. So it's that kind of storm. A wind storm. That is what Ezekiel saw. The Lord your God. Hallelujah. So he says, I saw a wind storm coming out of the north. Yes, you see, an immense cloud, a huge cloud with flashes, flashing lightning, a lot of lightning, pia pia. Hallelujah.
Amen.
With a lot of fury. I say, there is a lot of fury, a lot of what is fury in Ashwama? Yes, you can say. But this is a different kind of monona. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And surrounded by brilliant light. The center of the fire. You see again the fire. The center of the fire looked like glowing metal. Hallelujah. Glowing metal. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then he says, and in the fire. So the fire does not just come out of him. So the fire is also around him. So he himself is fire. Hallelujah. Look at this. In the center. So he says the center of the fire looked like glowing metal. In the center. Yeah. And then in the fire was what looked like four living creatures. Their appearance, in appearance, their form was human. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But each of them had four faces and four wings. Their legs were straight. Their feet like those of a calf and gleaming like burnished bronze. Under their wings, in on their four sides, they had human hands. All four of them had four faces and four wings. All of them. All four of them. They had four faces. They had faces and wings. And the wings of one touched the wings of another. Each one went straight ahead. They did not turn as they moved. So their wings are like this. They are touching each other. And they are going forward. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And they are in the fire. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then in that middle then we have this what looked like glowing metal. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then it says, their faces looked like this. Each one had had the face of a human being. And on the right side, each had the face of a lion. And then on the left, the face of an ox. And then they had each two wings spreading upward. And each wing touching that of the creature on either sides. And each of them had two wings that are covering the body. And each one of them went straight ahead. Wherever the Spirit would go, they would go. So now there is also the Spirit. Hallelujah. So there is the Spirit and then the four living creatures. So it says when the Spirit goes, then they go also. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's a very powerful picture there. And it says wherever the Spirit would go, they would go. Without turning as they went. This is the complete unison. Hallelujah. This is the perfect oneness. Hallelujah. Because there is no double mindedness. No, each one has the same mind as the other. When the Spirit is moving, they also move. When the Spirit goes left, they also go left. When the Spirit goes right, they also go right. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then he says, the appearance of the living creatures was like burning coals of fire. Or like torches. So they are also called the burning ones. Yes. The burning ones, the ones that are burning with fire, not just with light. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They are called the burning ones. Then it says, fire moved back and forth among the creatures. It was bright. And the lightning flashed out of the fire. We are trying to understand the God that created you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He says, as I looked at the living creatures, I saw a wheel on the ground beside each creature with its four faces. Hallelujah. So here comes the wheels now. Yes, so he says he looks at the creatures. And as you see the creature here, underneath there is a wheel. Then another creature, underneath is a wheel. Another creature, underneath is a wheel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
A wheel.
Elola.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So he says,
that's
I saw a wheel on the ground beside each creature with its four faces. Then, look verse 16, there was the appearance and the structure of the wheel. This was the appearance. This was the appearance. And the structure. Of the wheels. It says, the wheels, they sparkled like topaz. And all four wheels, they looked alike. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Each wheel appeared to be made like a wheel intersecting a wheel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So it's like a wheel inside a wheel, or a wheel with another wheel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The mystery of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We
have not even scratched the surface. As they moved, the wheels, the creatures, they would go in any one of the four directions the creatures faced. So the wheels, they would go. So you have three things here now.
Or four,
you have the fire. You have the what looks like glowing metal in the fire.
The center,
and then you have around the fire. In the fire, you have the creatures. And then beside the creatures, you have the wheels. Four wheels. And then there is the spirit. Wherever the spirit goes, the wheel goes. The creatures go. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then it says, the wheels did not change direction as the creatures went. So the three of them are in perfect unison. Their rims were high and awesome. And all four rims were full of ice all around. The four wheels had eyes along the rims. That is God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then it says, when the living creatures moved, the wheels beside them also moved. And when the living creatures rose from the ground, the wheels also rose. So when the spirit moves, the creatures move and the wheels move also. And when the spirit lifts, the creatures lift and the wheels also lift. Verse 20, wherever the spirit would go, they would go. And the wheels would rise along with them. Because the spirit of the living creatures was in the wheels. When the creatures moved, they also moved. When the creatures stood still, they also stood still. And when the creatures rose from the ground, the wheels rose along with them. Because of the spirit of the living creatures was in them. Because the spirit of the living creatures was in the wheels. Spread out above the heads of the living creatures. Then there was something spread out above the
heads.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So it says now, so now there was something above the there was something that was spread. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It says, this what was spread out was what looked something like a vault. Hallelujah.
Amen.
A vault is a firmament, an opening, a space.
Evalelua.
Hallelujah. sparkling, and that space, that vault was sparkling like crystal, and it was awesome. And it was awesome. Under the vault,
he
says, under the vault, their wings were wings covering its body's weight. Under the vault, their wings were stretched out one toward the other, and each one had two wings covering the, its body.
Na keshishi mwishari shino mavava avali atu viga kompinga ei. Na keshishi mwishari atu viga kompinga inya ikwao.
And when the creatures moved, I heard the sound of their wings.
Deleso ina mwenye yenda, ondauta ontakayo mavava ayo. Epopololo mavava ayo.
When the creatures, okay, translate me, so we go faster. When the creatures moved, I heard the sound of their wings. Their wings, they sounded like the roar of a rushing waters. So that sound is like the sound when he speaks. So when he speaks, the voice sounds like the roar of rushing water. When the creatures flapped their wings sounded like the roar of rushing waters. Like he says here, like the voice of the Almighty. Like the tumult of an army, like a sound, a huge sound of an army. When they stood still, the creatures, they lowered their wings. Then there was a voice from above the vault over their wings as they stood with lowered wings. So you have the creatures, then you have the expanse, the vault, and then you have the voice above there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He says, now we have the voice. So when they stood still and then the voice spoke, then there came a voice from above the vault over their heads. As they stood with lowered wings. Above the vault over their heads was what looked like a throne of lapis lazuli. Lapis lazuli.
Lapis lazuli.
And high above on the throne. So you have the vault and then you have the throne. On top of the vault. And then on top of the throne you have that now this person. Above the vault, he says, and high above on the throne was a figure like that of a man. I saw that from what appeared to be his waist up. He looked like glowing metal. As if full of fire. And that from he says, and that from there down he looked like fire. Up is like glowing metal. Full of fire. Down, look like fire. And then a brilliant light surrounded him. Like the appearance of a rainbow in the clouds on a rainy day. So was the radiance around him. This was the appearance of the likeness of the glory of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is the glory of the Lord. That is how the glory of the Lord looks like. That's how the God that you worship looks like. That is the image in which you are created. When I saw it, I fell face down and I heard the voice of one speaking. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What is the time? Hallelujah.
Amen.
He says, how does God look like? The God who created you in his image. He said, like man. But it is man that like that is look like him, that looks like him. But when you look at him, you see the form of a man. He looks like man. Because man was created in his image. Man was created in his likeness. That's why when you look at him, you don't say he looks like a banana. You don't look at him and say he looks like a chimpanzee. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that is the God that created us in his glory. So when man was created, he was full of the glory of the Lord. He was fiery like the Lord. He was powerful like the Lord. He was glowing like the Lord. He had the knowledge of God. He had extraordinary knowledge like God. He could see far like the Lord. He had the understanding of God. He had the appearance of God. And he walked now in that form. He worshiped the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see the four living creatures that are fiery, that look like fire. They are fiery, they have fire in them. And they live in fire. And they are called the fiery ones. They worship the Lord. Day and night. They don't stop. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. In the same way, when he created man, he created man fiery like him, powerful like him, glorious like him. To worship him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To worship him. To worship God. To worship the Lord. To worship his creator. To worship Jehovah. To worship his maker. To worship his judge. Who is the creator of all things. All things that you see. The trees, the birds, mankind, the animals, the fish, the stars, the planets, the earth, the rivers, the oceans, the mountains. He created them all. Hallelujah. Now in that garden, so there was powerful worship going on. There was perfect worship. Because Adam and Eve, they walked in the perfect will of God. They looked like God. They were filled with the Spirit of God. And they worshiped God according to the Spirit of God. Wherever the Spirit was in them, they went. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They were in one accord. They worshiped the Lord on earth the same way that angels worship the Lord in heaven. Therefore, the worship on earth was exactly the same worship that was in heaven. So heaven and earth, they were in one accord. They worshiped the Lord together. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There was no discrepancy. There was no difference. They were in one accord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then the Lord said, There is a tree.
Opena omti.
I don't want you to eat from it.
Ihala maji
ako. It's called the tree of the knowledge of good and evil.
Omti wo kushiva o wanowi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord.
Omwene.
Was in the garden.
Kwale limo shikunino.
His throne was in the garden. His glory was in the garden of Eden. So in the garden of Eden, you literally had heaven on earth.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And God inhabited the earth. What was his plan? Hallelujah. What was the plan of the Lord? What was his plan? He said, be fruitful and multiply. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Be fruitful and multiply. Why? Why did he say, be fruitful and multiply? To Adam and Eve. The goal was this. So that when they multiply and they have their children, from their children to their children's children, to their children's children's children, to their children's 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 children, down the millionth generation. Hallelujah. That all of them, they are glorious, 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 glorious. You have glorious children. You have glorious offspring. Glorious image of God. Filling the whole earth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then, when you look at the earth, full of children that are glorious, 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 and they look like God, you would see the glory of the Lord essentially. What you would see when you look at the children of men filling the earth and they are glorious, when you look at the earth, you would see the glory of the Lord covering the earth as water covers the sea. And that was his plan for his glory to multiply and fill the entire earth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Very powerful. Hallelujah. He did not create, he did not say multiply, multiply, just so that you sleep around with people. No, there was a purpose. The purpose was not sexual immorality. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The purpose was not selfishness. The purpose was for the glory of the Lord to fill the earth. And that was the purpose. The grand purpose. And then you'd have heaven and earth in one accord. Glorious heaven and a glorious earth. And the will of God perfectly fulfilled on the earth. And then from the rising of the sun as far as the east is, to the setting of the sun as far west is, and as the sun is going all day long, when they wake up in the morning at the rising of the sun, they wake up worshiping the Lord. as the day is going by, they are worshiping the Lord. When the sun is going down, they are worshiping the Lord. So all day, they are worshiping the Lord. All the time, they are worshiping the Lord. All the everywhere, in every place, they are worshiping the Lord. That is the purpose, the plan of the Lord. That is plan A. Plan A is not to make you rich. Plan A is not to give you a big house. Plan A is to worship the Lord. Everywhere. Anywhere. All day. All the time. Hallelujah. All day. Every day. All week. Every week. All months, every month, all year, every year, every millennia, worshiping the Lord, don't stop. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That is plan A. Hallelujah. That is plan A. To worship the Lord. The question comes, have you worshiped the Lord? Have you really worshiped the Lord? There are some people, they are called submarine Christians. Yeah, like a submarine. So you have some Christians. They are submarine Christians. On Sunday, they come out of the waters to come and worship. Oh, we worship the Lord. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Monday morning, they go back under the waters. They don't want to worship. Don't even call them brother. They'll put you off. Hey, Brother Samuel.
Oh,
don't call me Brother Samuel. Hallelujah. They are called submarine Christians. But the Lord says, all day, every day, all the time, everywhere, anywhere, every single moment, ought to be worshiping the Lord. Hallelujah. Satan saw this.
Oh,
Satan
o kwamo naneji.
Jealous.
On tubo.
The jealous one.
On nandubo.
The envious one.
Oh, la fani, eto da fani.
You know, to envy is to want what you have.
Okukala.
What someone else have.
Oka.
To be envious is to want what someone else has.
Ano eni po ahale ikeshi kwa ina.
See, jealousy is to be angry that person has what they have. But envy, you want it.
Yeah?
Envy is when you want it. When you want what they have. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I was this defining the difference between jealousy and envy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So jealousy is when you are angry that someone has something. Envy is when you want it now to be yours. So the jealous one, the envious one, the proud one, the accuser of the brethren. Satan,
Satana,
the devil,
Ontonzi,
the snake,
Eoka,
the serpent,
Eoka,
the dragon. Hallelujah. The angry one. The unholy one. The unrighteous one. The one has been kicked out of heaven. He was jealous of men. envious of men. Because he has no second chance. He does not have a second chance until today. He cannot be saved. He cannot be redeemed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He cannot be redeemed. Redeemed is kupifwa, but it's to buy back. Yes, that one. Hallelujah. He cannot. He has no chance of repentance. So he decided. He went when he saw men full of glory, working with the Lord, faithful to God, working in the perfect will of God. He decided to ruin the life of man, so that man does not go to heaven. But so that man can lose the glory and then become a candidate of hell.